Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nicher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity, and here I'm going to describe how the Messianic Jews, they corrupted the church and put on wrong or misleading concepts. First of all, by mixing this Old Testament, which is a written Torah, which is the moral of Moses, and that apply to our physical body, and in whose the God is Yahweh. Yahweh is a jealous and revengeful God, whereas our Father in spirit, God, is loving and merciful. So they confused people who created Adam and Eve, whether it was Yahweh or it was our Father in spirit, which is God. God did not create Adam and Eve. God is spirit. What is born of spirit is spirit. So what is inside us, which we cannot see but we perceive, is of God. That is the soul. Not this physical body. Physical body is the regime of Yahweh. So again, these people, they confuse them. And then the first attack on the theology was the confusion in the understanding of Trinity. So they used to lure the people into their churches by telling them, don't you believe Jesus is the Son of God? And then Holy Spirit. So then all they put it together, they put, say, so this is the Trinity, Holy Son, Holy Father, and Holy Spirit. But they got so confused that they did not know the difference between Holy Spirit and Holy Ghost. They are two different things. The Trinity, as I have explained, is formed by three types of people. Whereas we have family of God, in which we have Son, and our Mother is Holy Spirit, and our Father is God. That is the family of God. In the Trinity, we have Holy Son, which is the children, once born people. Then we have Holy Father, which are twice born people, sensible. And then we have people who are wise people, who are sealed to serve God. They are called possessed by Holy Ghost. And then the Holy Spirit, which is the very Spirit of God, you attain it by the grace of our Father. So Holy Son, Holy Father, and Holy Ghost, they make the Trinity, not the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is different. So they confused them, and they confused other things, and they were just became the blind followers, blind guides of the blind people. And that is why today you have so many churches, Baptist church, Methodist church, this and that. They all reflect the degree of blindness people are in. So none of them seems to be sensible that if Jesus is one, then how can you have these so many churches in his name? Because John the Baptist, there are some Baptist churches, they are just saying, oh, we baptize like this and that ritual, you know. John the Baptist, he was a Levi priest, or ideal Levi priest, rabbi, or prophet Elijah. So he was not a son of, or he was not a saint, or son of God. So, how can you have a church in his name when he was not a saint? So, John the Baptist was a Levi priest. of the Jewish one. And he used to baptize in the name of Abraham, the father in secular father, or in father in physical covenant, our tribal covenant. So he did not, the bishop used to baptize them in the first the church was formed. Saint Stephen used to baptize in the name of Abraham, and that's why he went to Jerusalem temple to stress that we are sons of Abraham. And then after this death of Saint Stephen and Saint James the Just, the bishop slowly changed it to this baptism into Son, Holy Son, Holy Father, and Holy Ghost. That means in the name of God, you know. Whereas the John the Baptist was a witness to the light, but not the light. The least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist. So when they gave this baptism of Jesus, which was of light, and to this John the Baptist, then there was no baptism left for Jesus. Remember that these people were making Jews of the physical self. So these Messianic Jews turned around and they made the Christians of the physical self. So they were dead Christians. So these Messianic Jews then became super vipers, killing the spirit of the people. So those who could not be killed, they put them to stake to be burnt alive. So at the end, the church end up as a dead church. No spirit, no spiritual voice could be heard. If somebody resisted and opened his mouth, there is the Pope who will come up and put him to stake. Remember that in France, 300 to 400 Cathars were burnt alive in 1700 AD or so. So you can see how atrocities were being committed in the name of Jesus. So then the Holocaust started when Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he organized Islam to resist the popes. To fight the resistance, these popes then organized crusade, and Mohammedans organized jihad. So in the crusade and jihad, many people died, and they were all killed by the super vipers. So the super vipers, Messianic Jews, they are responsible for the deaths of people during in the crusade and also during this Holocaust, which took place in different countries. In Germany was the latest. So 5 million people died, and they were as the result of these super viper Messianic Jews. If the Messianic Jews had upheld the light of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus and should not have called him a Lord to make the people dead, to kill the people, then today such an Holocaust would not have happened, and the churches would not have been divided into Baptist, Methodist, and whatnot. So these churches are divisions, reflect the degree of blindness the people are living in. And to pull them out is not an easy job. Unless you are predestined, you cannot come out of this net. So this net of Antichrist is very strong. So Messianic Jews are responsible for this net.